The former principal of a Citrus Heights elementary school is under arrest tonight after a lengthy investigation into allegations that he molested students. Robert Adams faces 6 felony counts of assaulting children under 14 and a misdemeanor count of molesting a child under 18. He is accused of fondling 7 girls over a 15-year period. KCRA3's Chris Riva joins us live from the Creative Frontier School in Citrus Heights, which Adams ran. Chris?
Edie, this school has remained closed since the case went public back in July. This is certainly a case that has cut deep into the community where many people want the school to reopen.
Our hearts go out to all of the children.
This guy will get his.
I will believe in him. The whole thing just stinks.
An investigation and now an arrest that has divided a community.
It's a tragedy, and I can't believe that this happened to my child.
This man says his daughter is one of the 7 victims police have built their case on. We're concealing his identity to protect his daughter. Robert Adams is accused of child molestation dating back 15 years. The news of his arrest has only deepened the stance of both sides.
I watched the supporters, you know, God bless them, you know, for whatever they thought, but these people weren't directly involved.
He's a great person of the community. He's run an absolutely awesome school for the past 35 years.
Guilty or innocent, the Creative Frontier School remains closed. It's been shut down since July because of the allegations.
The more this goes on, the more difficult it is going to be to reopen this school.
Today, police along with city leaders expressed hope that the school will open again. Volunteers here say they've been working to get the school to compliance, adding they have no idea what's next.
Aside from the allegations with Robert Adams, the school is an academic icon.
And as for Adams tonight, when he was arrested this morning, he complained of chest pains and was transported to Mercy San Juan Hospital, where he'll remain overnight for observation. He is in police custody, but once he's released from the hospital, he'll be booked into the Sacramento County Jail. Reporting live from Citrus Heights, Chris Riva, KCRA 3 reports.